us here this morning. I'm Rachit, and along with me is my colleague, Pragun Shukla. We are here. Okay. Good. So we are here to talk about our solution, Humanitarian in the Sky. And before we do that, I would like to play a small video. Seen was the Gorkha earthquake of Nepal, which happened in April 2015. It nearly killed 9,000 people and injured 22,000 people. The act of nature creates a catastrophic situation in which the day-to-day pattern of lives are suddenly disrupted, and people are plunged into helplessness and suffering. According to the 2013 civil registration data released by Census Directorate, around 27% of the total death in India is due to the lack of timely treatment. So if out of, which means like 3 out of 10 people who die during these calamities and natural disasters are the victims of lack of timely treatment or the delayed treatment. So knowing this, that we know that timely response is such a significant factor in saving lives, still it's a matter of great concern. So this is one such example where we are talking about the earthquake, but these kind of calamities happen anytime in and around us. So I'll be moving. Yeah. So this is the earthquake, and the epicenter was Kathmandu of Nepal, the capital. So as you can see, the relief camp was put right there, but because of the direct route to the relief camp was heavily disrupted by the earthquake, people had to take the green route, which is like a much time-taking route, as well as we know it's an undeniable situation and there's not much we can do about it. But we do know during the time which has gone in taking the longer route, people would have been saved, and some way they could have been a better response to it. So in response to this, the IBM call for code, along with the David Clark clause, has initiated a global challenge in a worldwide developer competition that seeks technologies, solutions for natural disaster, preparedness, recovery, and response. Motto behind Call for Code is to bring out the developers and creating open source technologies for healthcare, which can reduce the risk of diseases, create options for emergency care, improve data and resources availability, and help victims navigate the psychological support needed throughout the crisis. So our solution to this is the first means of help to the people affected during natural disaster. And in order to do that, we are providing virtual assistance to the victims by giving them support by the volunteer medical staff, doctors available throughout the globe who want to help them at the time of natural calamities. But yeah, there's a limitation that all of them could not reach or cannot reach the disaster affected area physically. So what can be done in that case? So we are in order to do so, in order to reach to that, we have leveraged Watson APIs, and we're gonna show simple how we have achieved this. So maybe Pragun can take over here.
Yeah, thanks, Rachit. Yeah, so hello everyone. So this is the high level architecture of our model. So basically we are using a self-assembled and a self-programmed drone. So we have a Raspberry Pi device and it will be interfaced with a Pi camera. So the use of the Pi camera here is to capture the live video stream of the surrounding objects, and it will send it as an input to the Raspberry Pi device. So within the Raspberry Pi device, we have implemented an object detection model. So it will differentiate between different categories of objects, like maybe a person, an animal, or a vehicle, and so on. So so once it recognizes that an object is a person, then it will take the images of that person from various angles and send it as an input to the visual recognition service. So in this using this visual recognition service, we have made a model which we have trained with over around 5K images. So these images consisted of both injured people and non-injured people. So we are using IBM Watson for that. So this model will detect whether a person is injured or not. So suppose if it finds that a person is injured, then it will make a direct call to a physician or some emergency doctor who could guide the patient on like what first aid he should apply, or any nearby volunteer who could help the patient in treating the patient. So if the person is found to be not injured, then there he will be provided with a set of questions which will be of behavioral type. So like the questions might be like, how are you feeling, or are you in any kind of pain? So the responses of the victim will be captured by a microphone which will be placed over the drone. So once the responses of the victims are captured, it will again be sent to this speech-to-text Watson service. So what it will do, it will convert those audio clips into text. So Watson generally supports like 5 major languages, Spanish, English, and Japanese, and so on. But if suppose we want it for some regional languages, like maybe Tamil and Hindi, Punjabi, or something, so for that also there are many open source libraries available, so we can use those also. So once we get the text for this audio clips, it will send that text to the NLP model which we have created using natural language understanding service, which is again offered by IBM Watson. So inside this model, we have created an algorithm which will, based on certain keywords, it will find whether a person is suffering from any kind of general disease like a fever, or maybe some kind of internal injury, or maybe if a person is suffering from any kind of mental trauma, maybe due to absence of any of his family members. So it will be able to detect, and it will make a call accordingly. So if a person is suffering from any disease, then it will make a call to a general doctor, and he will guide what medicines he should take. And if he's suffering from any kind of mental trauma, then a call will be made to a counselor or a psychiatrist, so he can calm down the person and guide him what further steps he should take. So for calling feature, we are using a GSM module, which will also be mounted on the drone. So this was the high level architecture of our model. Then, so the coming to the object detection model. So we have made this model using the code patterns which are already available in the open source platform of IBM. So anyone can use those. So if you want to know more details about it, you can go to developers.ibm.com and you will find many such code patterns which you can integrate in your any of your applications and make the work easy. So,
could you please play the video? Yes, please.
Yeah. So, as you see, as you can see from the video, that it was able to detect a person even from behind. So, even if the image is not like complete, if it is a partial image, which may be the case in case of natural disasters, since the drone might not be able to capture the complete image of a person, like if he is stuck in any debris or something. So it might capture the partial image, but still the model is able to detect with certain accuracy that it is a person. And also the cat image, it was a little blurred. So in that case also, we might, in the practical scenario, we might not get a high resolution image of the surroundings. So in that case also, the model is able to predict the correct results. So it can be relied on for practical scenarios. So coming to the next slide. So these are some output from our object detection model. So you can see it can differentiate, how it can differentiate between living things and non-living things. In the fourth image, you can see that a group of persons are roaming and a vehicle is there. So still it is able to predict the correct category of the objects with over 90% of accuracy. So now coming to the estimated cost of this model. So the estimated cost is roughly around 18K in Indian rupees. So you can notice that even if you go to the market to buy a smartphone nowadays, it is very much more than this price. So if our model is able to save even a single life also, then it will be truly worthy of the resources invested in making it live. So next. So this is our simple structure of our hardware component. So you can see how the Raspberry Pi device is mounted over the drone. And next. So this is the Raspberry Pi device. This strip-like structure, which you can see, is the Pi camera, which will capture the live video stream of the surroundings. And this blue color device is the GSM module with an antenna, which will be used for making the calls. Yes, so this is our dashboard application for our product. So here we can upload the image or audio input, and it will analyze in the backend what type of health issues are there. So we are focusing basically on three issues: external injury, psychological, and general health issues. So suppose we take for external injury, so we will upload an image of a person who is having an external injury. So you can see like here. So it is uploaded. Then we will analyze. So once we press this analyze button, it will invoke the visual recognition model which we have created in the backend. So it will invoke that model and it will give the results. So here you can see it is able to correctly predict the victim is injured and the accuracy is 92%. So now coming to a non-injured category. So again, we will select the external injury and we will upload the image of a non-injured person this time. So once it is uploaded, again, the same model which we created in using the visual recognition service will be invoked. And this time it is able to predict that the victim is not injured. And this time also it is giving a high accuracy of 89%. So it can be relied upon. So now we will check for the audio inputs. So suppose a victim is having some general health issues. So we will upload the audio file for that, which will be having the responses of the victim, which will be captured by microphone, which attached to the drone. So once it is uploaded, so this time two services of Watson are called, speech to text, and then the other service called is NLP. Volume is not coming.
Okay, we cannot hear the audio, but it's fine. What exactly happens is we are taking the audio response from a victim, and then we are doing a speech to text conversion, and we are providing the transcript. So if the person is saying, I'm not physically hurt, but I'm having headache, and I'm having feeling that I might faint. So in that case, we know that the person might need a general doctor help, and that's where we are giving that accuracy.
Yeah, so coming to psychological issues, we will again upload an audio file. So again, the two services will be called. The APIs for those will be invoked. So again, it will give the audio transcript.
My
of
mental
that.
Condition is not stable. I don't know what to do. I am in need of help.
So it converts that speech to text, then perform the NLP over that. So it is able to correctly predict based on certain keywords like mental condition, not stable. It is able to predict correctly that the person is suffering from some mental trauma. So accuracy also you can see is 78% for this. So we have also maintained a database of all the available and non-available doctors. So we have divided the doctors into three categories, which are general physicians and counselors and the emergency doctors. So general physicians will be treating the external injuries, counselors will be taking care of some mental trauma, and emergency doctors will be taking care of general diseases like fever or some epidemic which might spread during disasters. So if the doctor is available, then it will show with a green signal, and if a doctor is not available, then it will show as a red signal. So it will not make a call to those doctors which are not available at that moment.
Thank you, Pragun. So yes, before I go to that, so we, as we Pragun shared, that we are keeping the database of the doctors who want to volunteer for the cause or for these kind of natural disasters. So at the time, we are trying to make call to the 10 doctors from the database and check if anybody picks it up. Whoever picks it up, at the same time, the victim will be assigned to that doctor. And at the same time, we are marking that doctor as occupied or busy. So in doing that, if none of the doctors pick or none of the help can be provided, then we call the next 10 people in the slot. So doing that, we are trying to bring out help to the people in a more timely manner, and avoiding the 3% of the people or like the 3 out of 10 people who die. So we want to make that count reduced by doing so. And this was an initiative by the IBM Cloud Call for Code, which I've already mentioned. So any Q&A or you want to go ahead? Yeah.
Yeah, so I would like to tell so in this complete product, we have integrated three, four Watson services. Then we have used a code pattern, which is present in the open source platform of IBM. So we can see in such less time using those services and with the help of that code pattern, we can integrate all those things and build a product. So suppose anyone has a great idea, but he is not aware of any programming languages. So he can easily use these services of IBM Watson and implement his idea, and it will not take much time and efforts. So you just need to sign into a free IBM Cloud account, then you just have to create your model, then train it with some data set, then within 3-4 hours you will be ready with the model, so you can integrate it with your product. So it will be very useful if someone is willing to make some product or application for their own business requirements.
Yeah, Vero.
Yeah, so a couple of questions.
Yeah.
From the same image in there, right? When you're uploading an image, if it is coming from a drone, I'm assuming that you cannot hire people to then keep asking them to choose. Right, so is there any way that you automate it where every image that is coming is automatically captured as right physically hurt or not and then given accuracy to that? Right, that is one question. Number two, right, when we know that individual is already
can we answer one by one? Like,
I think it goes together.
Okay, goes. So, yeah, okay, sure.
When you know somebody is already hurt, you know him bleeding, right? Why the accuracy is 98%, 92%, why not it is 100%?
Yeah, so coming to your first question, your question was that why we have to upload the image manually and it doesn't predict the results by its own. So the answer is that the application which we have showed is just the dashboard of that model which we have showed to show you what's happening in the backend. But in the real-time scenario, these all computations will be done within the Raspberry Pi component. So that will only detect the person, then it will predict the whether he is injured or not, then he will give the it will give the results. So there will be no application for that. This is just for the demo purpose. And coming to your second question, what was it?
It was about
the accuracy of the
So we have used around 5K images consisting of both injured and non-injured people. So we can, anyhow, we can like use some other model or maybe change, make some fine tuning with the data set which we are uploading to increase the accuracy. And also like in some cases, like there might be some cases like the severity of injury is very high. And in some cases, the severity of injury is not very high, like a simple cut or something is there. So the model, it is automatically detecting whether what type of severity the person is having. So based on that, it is predicting whether how much percentage of accuracy should give. So you have a good point actually, why it is not giving 100%, because it is, we can see like he is hurt. So that any time we can use some custom model for that. So we have just used what was provided by default by the Watson service. But if we want to increase or further tune our results, we can anytime create a custom model, and that that facility is also provided by the IBM Watson. So you can anytime do that.
So basically, when we started, the accuracy was not that good. It was close around 60%. But with just 5,000 images we uploaded, and it came to 80 or 90%. So what Pragun is saying rightly is we have used the code patterns which were already available in public space of IBM. So with those, if you keep on, you can fine tune it and you can make it more improvised with more optimized results can come by uploading more data to it.
Yeah. So I also have some couple of questions. So I'll start from one by one.
Sure.
So what is the distance between from the land to drone? What's the distance? What is the maximum distance kilometers from land to a drone?
So yeah. What we have done is, okay, you want to answer? Go ahead.
Yeah, so it depends on how you program the drone for flying.
Okay.
So there is a software called Autopilot that is basically used for flying the drone. So in which way you want to fly the drone, you can set with that software. So the distance which you want, like if you want at a higher distance, you can set it at a higher distance. If you want a less distance, maybe if some debris or something is there, then you can keep the height as low. So it depends on your requirements.
To get the more like clarity of the images. And
Yeah, that's what my question is. If it's very long distance, say about 5 kilometer, 10 kilometer, how it's able to capture the image from the drones?
Okay. In that manner, we need
yeah,
to...
Yeah, so as we showed, like, even yeah. the image was taken from behind the person. So even in that case, also it was able to predict with 80% accuracy. So it is just the model which we are using is trained, whoever is, has created that model. We are just using a code pattern. So whoever has created that model, it can be relied upon because even with the back images or the cat image which we showed was a little blurred image. Even for that, it showed 70 to 80% accuracy. So that's what...
I can answer it. Like object detection model which we have used, we have provided the images from almost like you can say 100 meter or 200 meters from the top, and it was able to give it with 70 to 80% accuracy because that's how the model is defined. It can differentiate very easily, and I think that should answer it. Like,
so if it is if a 2 kilometer, 3 kilometer from that land, so it is able to capture that image?
Yes, yeah. Based on the camera, like what camera you'll be using.
So what camera you are using in this case?
So we have used, just for the demo purpose, we have used a low resolution Pi camera, but we can increase the resolution as we want, like as required.
Okay. Yeah. So if from the drone, so it will use to capture that bird view, means the top view. So how you will get that like a side view of that person's. So yeah. From the drone we used to capture from like a almost like a...
Correct. So we are taking from all possible angles. So it's not only the top view.
Okay.
We try to take from the side as lateral views and maybe 40 degree from that. So we try to capture all possible views if possible, and then we are going to differentiate.
Okay. So this model is running on the inside the drone itself, or it is in the any cloud or this?
So it is in the IBM cloud for now. So we just have to call that service using the APIs. And it will be triggered and give us the results for our application.
So from drone Raspberry Pi to the cloud service?
Yeah.
So even all the training and the deployment happening in the?
Yeah, Raspberry Pi. No. That will be happening in the IBM cloud. And it will fetch the results and that computation will happen in the Raspberry Pi.
Okay. So what kind of object detection you are using? You're using YOLO 3 or like a single dot detection, SSD, or which algorithm?
Yeah. Yeah, so we have used the code pattern, as we told, the code pattern which was available on IBM.
So you do not
IBM.
Require the complete knowledge of it, because these code patterns are defined in such a way that whatever technologies you are saying, or maybe the dotted one which you said, it could be used properly because there are a lot of code patterns. So you don't have to get your hands dirty by coding from the very scratch.
Okay.
You can directly call these, and if you don't like that efficiency, maybe you can model them as per your need. But there are like thousands of such models and being readily available on the public GitHub.
Okay.
So if you want to like optimize the results, then you can make a custom model also, and or the models which are already available, as you told, like single shot multi-box detector or YOLO. YOLO is better, I think, for object detection in such cases. So you can use anytime those also.
The last question. Natural disaster, that the sound, so that the people, so means that too much, too crowd, right? So the noise will, the sound will be too noisy. So how we are filtering that noise?
So for that, we have tried another, there is a small filtering in Watson, I guess, which can take out the background noises from the actual noise.
Okay.
So it can go up to, I cannot say it can be like completely 100%, but yeah, it can definitely give you a proper response or audio file.
Yeah, so that could be the multiple people are like in the crowd, there is multiple people, one people speak in Tamil or other people English or different language, how it will be taken care?
So in that case, currently we are just relying on the English one. And as we said, that the Watson services or the Watson speech to text works only on few languages, which are globally known. But for these, we can use open source technologies where we can do the conversion based on the need. And yes, you have a very good question that maybe a lot of people are talking. That's a very, very real time scenario. So in that case, we can identify like how many people are talking in different languages, maybe based on the what decibel level they are talking, and maybe different kind of languages they are using. So we can differentiate them, and then probably multiple people, doctors, or can be provided help, or maybe one can help all of them at the same time.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for one second.
Thank you.
Hello? Yeah.
Okay.
So if you have detected that there are multiple people who are injured, how do you prioritize, which person should be treated first, or a single drone will be allotted to each, or what is the plan?
Yeah, that's a very good question, because we have been asked this question a lot of times. So what we are doing is we are cropping the images. So if an image has, like, let's suppose three people are injured, so we are just cropping them on the time, and then we are just delivering it to the individual doctors. But yeah, there can be multiple drones taking care of individual persons, but splitting of the image in the real time using the one drone is a more feasible option, as you cannot provide 100 drones for the 100 people. So it's better to take one drone and take picture of 10 people and then just crop it them and give it to the respective services which we are using in Watson.
And then what is the action that will be taken for that particular patient? So you have detected that there are three people who are injured, and you have probably assigned three doctors for each of the patients. Then what is the action? Do you send any payload using the drone, or okay, what is the action?
So the major difference, what we are trying to do is, at the time of, even in the medical camps, you can see people are standing in a queue. And although they don't, they can directly go to the medical camp and ask for a particular medicine or whatever injections, whatever they require. But being first being consulted by the doctor and then taking a transcription of that and then going to the medical and get it is a more timely response. So what we are doing is we are capturing whatever the doctor says and whatever doctor recommends, and you can directly go and get those things. So it need not have to be the medical camps, but you can directly go wherever the readily available medicines or payload is coming from. So you know, right, at the time of natural calamities, the army and all these people, they get the payloads for the people. So these people are not well trained. Like, they have well trained, but they don't have that much time to treat everybody. At that time, if somebody comes handy and they can say, can you give me this, because I've been asked by the doctor somewhere there and he has asked me to take these tablets, it's probably going to help me out. So that's a very fast response.
Okay. Suppose you have like three patients, and so you have assigned three doctors. So how? So there is one. Only you have that GSM that is mounted on your drone, right?
Yep, yep.
So it can make a call only. I mean, a single call at a time, probably, right?
No, with this we can do multitasking. Like, multi-threading is happening. So a lot of calls can happen at the same time. It need not have to be
so
one.
Drone will be able to pick different audios at the same time, and...
Okay, now you're asking about the audios.
Yeah, audios, basically.
Okay, in that case, like as I said, it has to basically identify how many people are there, and then based on their response, other doctors will be assigned. But that's a very real-time scenario, and yeah, I know it's a very good question to answer, but at this point, we have come to this, so this is what...
Maybe, yeah.
Thanks.
Increase the number of drones.
Okay, it's time. So yeah, I know it sounds very exciting. So you can meet us at the IBM booth. We are going to be there outside. You can know a lot about the exciting and interesting code patterns, and maybe sign up for the IBM cloud. And then there are some exciting swags which you can look into. So thank you guys for joining us here.
Thank you.